My name's Essie Davis. I'm here with the Babadook at Frightfest. I'm very proud that our film is here in London and that it is part of such an outstanding film festival right in the centre of London. I hope that people will not expect horror from it, because I think that it is more moving, perhaps a little bit more like a psychological thriller. And I'm really proud for everyone. We made this on the smell of an oily rag, and all of the effects are in camera. And it was a very blood, sweat and tears production with lots of love, and I'm just really proud that it's a part of this.
For people who haven't seen the film yet, can you just give us a quick synopsis of what The Babadook is all about?
It's a story of a single mum and her 6¾-year-old child, whose husband has died on the way to giving birth to their son. And this is approaching his 7th birthday. He's a child who is sure there are monsters in the cupboard who are going to come and kill his mother and himself. And he builds lots of weapons. And a book arrives on their bookshelf called Mr. Babadook, that eerily represents all of the things that he is frightened of. And it's really the story about facing your fear and the power of love. I think that there is something about feeling fear and having that sense of vulnerability when we're often in big cities, we just put up our walls and put on our blinkers and you know, get on with the day, and you have to be tough about everything, and you let fear in and you feel kind of alive. And you also recognize that it's a universal kind of feeling, and it does bring us back to our animal state of that kind of adrenaline. Mind you, my character in The Babadook feels a lot of fear, and I would have to say terror is one of the most exhausting emotions. I had to be terrified for weeks on end, and it was hard work. There was a lot of challenging scenes and a lot of moments where we were giggling our heads off. I guess because all of the effects are in camera, there were some very ridiculous moments as well. But there's a point in the film where there's a few cockroaches that start appearing, and particularly a lot that start crawling out of a little hole in the wall. And you know, we were in a studio set, and on the other side of the wall was the props guy with a straw blowing cockroaches through the hole that I was reacting to on the other side, but often they'd go in the other direction. And it was a brand new studio in South Australia, and we had all of these sort of fridge chilled cockroaches to try and keep them a bit slow, and they just got blown on, crawled into his throat, ran as fast as they could, and we now have got a total cockroach infestation in the studio. We introduced them.
Ruined a new studio. I guess obviously for a lot of people, there's usually at least one horror film that's left a big impression on them. For you personally, is there a horror film that really made an impact on you?
There have actually been many, but I would have to say The Shining is the one that leaps into my mind. I think that was a terrifying and wonderful, you know, beautiful piece of cinema, as well as terrifying, as well as just great storytelling and leaving a lot up to the audience's imagination. But I don't know. When I was a kid, I snuck in and saw Damien, The Omen. Oh no! On my brother's television in some replay. But I think the scariest of all has to be Jaws, right?
My final question: have you got a message to fans about this film and why they should be rushing out to watch it when they get a chance?
I think that particularly any parents who are up for this should come and see it, because I think it's a really moving experience, and they'll feel like perhaps they're not so bad and they're not alone.